Sefer Bamidbar is the only one of the books of the Torah that actually has a place marker in the middle, separating it into two parts. There are upside down nuns right in the middle of this week's parsha. This week's parsha ends off the process of getting ready to go towards Eretz Yisrael. In Parsha Bamidbar and Naso, we learn about the structure of Bnei Yisrael and where they're counted and they're ready to move on. In this week's parsha, we learn about how they get ready, how the Ananei HaKavod work, how the blasts of the shofars, and then all of a sudden, the parsha split into two by two nuns. And the two nuns separate clearly between what seems to be everything going in the right direction, towards building the nation, towards the Kedusha of Sefer Vayikra, and going into the land of Israel and implementing all that we have worked for over the past three books of the Torah, and the downfall of that reality not working out as planned. As we go into the complaints, we go into the sins of the Meraglim, Korach, and everything seems to go downhill from there as the Jews wander in the desert for 40 years. The first of the sins, the first thing that goes wrong is the complaints and the Itavu Ta'ava. It says in the Parshat Daf, Safsuf came together, Vitavu Ta'ava, and they said, Mi yochlonu basar. They had a passionate need for something. And they say, who's going to give us meat? And they ask, we want meat, and they fight for meat, and then at the end of the day, they get meat coming out of their noses. Now, what seems to be the message of the Torah here is that having taiva, having this passion for physical enjoyment and pleasure is something which is negative. How dare you want meat? You should want more spiritual things. It seems like the Torah is going against enjoying yourself and physical enjoyments and pleasuring yourself in that way. And so therefore, it's coming to say, you should think about more holy things, more spiritual things, and stop wanting to eat meat. However, if you look in Sefer Devarim, the opposite is written in the Torah. It says in the Torah, in Sefer Devarim, that V'chitava nafshecha l'cho basar, b'chol ava nafshecha tocha basar. When you come to a point where you have a taiva, you have an inclination to eat meat, go for it. B'chol ava nafshecha, whatever your heart desires, go and eat that meat. It seems kind of strange. In our parsha, when Afsafsuf itavu tava, they had a tava to go eat meat. They're put down, they're punished, and it's the start of the downfall of Bnei Yisrael and Sefer Bamidbar. However, in Sefer Dvarim, when we come and say, we want to eat meat, HaKadosh Baruch Hu comes and says, B'chol avat nafshecha, tocha basar, go for it, enjoy it. We want you to have a good time and enjoy the meat and the sustenance of the land. What's going on? What's the difference between B'chol avat nafshecha, tocha basar, and V'itavu ta'ava? Rav Hirsch explains that really HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem, wants us to enjoy this world. There's even a Gemara in the Yerushalmi that says that anybody who does not enjoy this world, mechayev benafsho, he's liable on his own life because he doesn't go out and enjoy this world. And because of that, certain Amoraim used to go and try new foods every single day. There's a mitzvah to go and enjoy the world that Hashem has given us. If that's the case, then what was wrong with what the Afsafsuf did in this week's parsha? I think the explanation is in the wording Vitavu Ta'ava. They didn't want meat. They wanted taiva. They wanted to pleasure and just to pleasure that pleasure. It wasn't about seeing meat and saying, wow, that's an incredible creation. That's an incredible taste. I'm going to enjoy that. There was no end. The end started with themselves and ended with themselves. It was about just fulfilling their own ta'avot and nothing more than that. And from there, you're not going to be satisfied by anything that comes afterwards. Because it's all about fulfilling that taiva, and then that taiva is going to grow into another taiva, into another taiva. And at the end of the day, it's only self-pleasuring and not enjoying the world for some sort of end. Even if that end is only to simply enjoy the world that Hashem has given us. To simply go around the world and to partake in what the world has to offer. That in itself is not a negative thing. That in itself can be used for wonderful, incredible ways of understanding the beauty that Hashem has given us. As we say in the bracha achrona, after we eat or drink anything that is not grown from the land or from Birkat HaMazon. As we said, Boreinu Vashot Rabot V'Chesronan. We thank Hashem for the Rabot, the great things. We thank Hashem for things that we didn't necessarily need and were not necessities, but rather they were just for our enjoyments. Enjoying the world is not something in itself inherently that is wrong. It's when that enjoyment is only pointed not at something else, not in a higher means, or even just any means for accomplishing something more productive, but rather only on self-replication and self-pleasure, that's where things fall apart. And that's where things fall apart for Am Yisrael as we go into the second half of Sefer Bamidbar. Shabbat Shalom.